Students, today we will continue with the protist clear, and today we will discuss about the eucalyptus, slime molds, protozoan, protists. So let us discuss the topic.
So first of all, let us discuss about the eucalyptus. Now, what are the characteristics of eucalyptus? You can see they are unicellular flagellated protists. Yeah, so they are unicellular flagellated. They generally reside in the fresh water or in damp soil. The body, you can see, it is more or less spindle shaped, clear, the pointed towards the end with a blunt middle area, clear, and broad middle area, and comparatively blunt at the anterior end. And the body is covered with a fine covering, clear, called pellicle. So body is covered with a fine covering called pellicle. Pellicle is nothing but an elastic protein. This pellicle is nothing but an elastic protein, which is mainly composed of this obliquely arranged, you can see here, this obliquely running parallel strips called myonyms. So these are pellicles are mainly made up of obliquely arranged parallel strips, which are called myonyms. Clear? And these are present underlying the cell membrane. Cell wall is absent. So these are present underlying the cell membrane, but there is no cell wall. Now, another thing is that two different types of flagella you can see here. One is the long one and another is the short one. Clear? So, two different types of flagella. This is called heterocone flagella. So, this type of flagella, when one is long and other is short, this is called heterocone flagella. They arise from the point which is called blepharoplast. Clear? So they arise from a point that is called blepharoplast, and this is united at the base, which is called paraflagellar body. Clear? So they arise from a point called blepharoplast and gets united at a point called paraflagellar body. Now, this paraflagellar body is photosensitive. The long flagellum is thin shell type. That means they have, you can see here, fine the hair-like structure. So this type of row of, these are called mastigonyms. So this long flagella is thin shell type with mastigonyms. And in addition to the flagellar movement, they can also have wriggling movement by contraction, expansion and contraction of their body. So they have two types of movement. One is they have flagella, clear? This flagella, they have two types of flagella. So they call, it is called heterocone flagella, which arise from a point called blepharoplast, clear, and united at a point called paraflagellar bodies. And this paraflagellar body is photosensitive, clear? So it is sensitive to light. And so this, the two types of flagella, one is long and thin shell type, that you can see the mastigonyms on the flagella, that hair-like structures, and other is, one is short, and but they have flagellar movement obviously, but apart from that, they can have wriggling movement by contraction and expansion of their body. They can also move. So you can see here, there is a eye spot. Clear? Here there is an eye spot or stigma, it is called, which is orange to red, and it is called and contains the pigment called astaxanthin. And if you go on for the mode of nutrition, they have mixotropic mode of nutrition. That means they can act, they can take their food by autophytic mode of nutrition, by a holophytic mode of nutrition, or they can take the food by holozoic mode of nutrition. That means they can perform photosynthesis in presence of light. They have the
pigments like chlorophyll A, chlorophyll that chlorophyll A, chlorophyll xanthophyll, keratin here. So they have different photosynthetic pigment, chlorophyll B, all these are present here, and but in absence of light they can have holozoic mode of nutrition, that means they can engulf certain substances, or they may have saprophytic mode of nutrition, they can absorb the decomposed or digested matter from the association or surrounding. So, and the reserve food is paramyelin, which is a carbohydrate, this carbohydrate type of food, and they, if you go on for the reproduction, they are mainly reproduced by binary fission, and that also in longitudinal axis. Their reproduction is mainly by binary fission, and that also in longitudinal axis. Sexual reproduction is very rare. It is so mostly the asexual reproduction, and that also binary fission in longitudinal axis is the main mode of reproduction. And the most significant thing of this group is that the Euglena, you can see here in the mode of nutrition, they have the saprophytic as or holophytic as well as the photosynthetic. So they provide the evolutionary phase. If you go on for the evolutionary context, they provide a very significant, they are very significant as they provide a link between the plant and the animals. Clear? As they provide a link between the plants and animals, so they are very significant in the evolution, in the point of evolution. So another group of protists are the slime molds. Clear? So another group of protists are the slime molds. They are fungi. Commonly they are called fungi like protists. So what character do the fungi have? So think, what character do the fungi have? So they are, do not have chlorophyll. Obviously fungi do not have chlorophyll, cannot perform photosynthesis. They are surrounded by plasma membrane only here, and somatic parts are without cell wall. But unlike fungi, they do not have any cell wall. They are surrounded by the plasma membrane only. And they generally reproduce by forming spores. At any one stage of life, they have an amoeboid structure. So in any one stage of life cycle, they have some amoeboid structure, and their main mode of nutrition is saprophytic. So they are very fungi-like, as because they like the fungi, they do not have chlorophyll. They are generally saprophytic like that of the fungi, and they do not have this locomotory organ. They mainly reproduce by spore formation, and also sexual reproduction is there by spore formation. So all these are characters very close to fungi. So these are called fungi like protists or slime molds. Now there are two types of slime molds. One is the acellular slime mold, that means they do not have any proper cell. Clear? Acellular, the sexual, the somatic bodies here are free living, multinucleate, naked, diploid, protoplasmic mass. Clear? So it is free living, multinucleate, naked, without any covering. The cell nuclei are diploid, that means having 2N chromosome. And this structure is called plasmodium. So they are free living. State is multinucleate, protoplasmic mass without any covering, with diploid nuclei, and this structure is called plasmodium or plasmodia. Now they are holocarpic, clear, and the sporangium, they forms a sporangium. You can see here, these are the sporangium, these are the elongated stalk with the sporangium at the top. So they can form sporangium
clear, and this parenchyma usually contain network of fine threads called capitulum. Generally, they are found in the decaying leaves or wood. So generally, they are found in the, just like the fungi, as because they have the saprophytic mode of nutrition, so they require the decaying areas, because therefore they can directly absorb the decaying or decomposed matter. They can directly absorb, and so the saprophytic mode of nutrition, they are generally found in the decaying leaves or wood. And since they are amoeboid, they move by pseudopodia. They form the pseudopodia, and they move by pseudopodia. And some of them are acellular slime mold, like Physalia are the common acellular slime molds, are Physalia, etc. And another type of slime molds are the cellular slime molds. Clear, these are flagellates. There is also absence of flagella and ball-less but uninucleate. They are also ball-less, but they are not multinucleate. They are uninucleate. Clear, ball-less, uninucleate are flagellated structure, which are called mixed amoeba. Clear, this structure is called mixed amoeba. Ball-less, uninucleate are flagellated structure called mixed amoeba, and they often forms pseudoplasmodium. So numerous mixed amoeba often join to form pseudoplasmodium. So they often form pseudoplasmodium. They are also holocarpic, and they produce sporangia, just like they also produce sporangia. And so sporangia produces the spores. Sexual reproduction here is generally anisogamy. That means two gametes are of two different types. The gametes which fuse are two different types, and during sexual reproduction, what happens? One of the mixed amoeba forms cluster of mixed amoeba, forms larger and engulf the smaller ones. So there are two different clear type of gamete formation. One becomes larger and engulfs the smaller cluster of mixed amoeba, and which is now called macrocyst. Here within which the karyogamy means the fusion of the nucleus occur, the nucleus fuses, and after that there is the nucleus fuses, and it is now called macrocyst. And finally, the macrocyst undergoes meiosis and forms numerous mixed amoeba. So sexual reproduction is anisogamous. One of the cluster of mixed amoeba becomes larger, which engulfs the smaller cluster. And there is the karyogamy, that is the fusion of the nuclei. And finally, it is called macrocyst. And finally, there is meiosis. So this is about the slime molds. An example of slime molds, there are various slime molds like Physalia, then Dictyostelium. So these are the common examples of the slime molds. Now next are the protozoan protists. They are microscopic cellular organisms with varied form, shape and symmetry. Clear? So they are microscopic with varied form. You can see here varied shape and symmetry. Their body is covered with, they don't have cell wall generally, their body is covered with fine pellicle. So their body is covered with fine pellicle, and sometimes it is also covered with silica or calcareous shell. And their locomotory organ are of varied. They may have flagella, they may have cilia, they may have pseudopodia, and some of them do not have any locomotory organ also. Nutrition is generally holozoic, saprophytic or parasitic. Either they are holozoic, that means they engulf the whole food, or they are sometimes saprophytic, or many of them are parasitic.
and they generally have contractile vacuoles, clear, which helps maintain their osmoregulation. For maintaining osmoregulation, they generally have contractile vacuoles. They reproduce by binary fission generally, and sometimes budding, multiple fission, these are also there. Sexual reproduction is by syngamy, that means they two gametes fuses, or sometimes they are conjugation is also there. So sexual reproduction is syngamy, or sometimes conjugation, where the two cells which are close to each other form a conjugating tube, and through which the genetic material is transformed from one cell to other. Now, according to their locomotory organ, generally they are subdivided into numerous types, like flagellated protozoans. Here, flagellated protozoans, these are generally called zooflagellates because they are non-photosynthetic with flagella, body covered with pellicle, generally by divided by binary fission. Here, and sexual reproduction is present by syngamy, that is fusion of two gametes. One of them example is trypanosoma. So they are flagellated protozoan protists. And trypanosoma, we know trypanosoma is very important for these causing disease. Trypanosoma gambiens, clear, which causes sleeping sickness, and that is carried by CC fly. The vector is the CC fly, which carries Trypanosoma gambiens, and it causes sleeping sickness. Another one is the Sarcodina. So another protozoan protist are the Sarcodina, clear, which have pseudopodia for locomotion and ingestion of food. So they have pseudopodia for locomotion and ingestion of the food, and they generally they are solitary, and nutrition is generally holozoic, that means they engulf the food. And they are amenotelic, they contain food vacuoles, clear, they contain food vacuoles, and the sol and gel theory, that means they have plasma gel, and inside the fluid is the plasma sol, which helps in the formation of the pseudopodia, is very common. The more they take food by phagocytosis or pinocytosis, and amoeba is the one of the commonest example of sarcodines. Apart from amoeba, one of the pathogenic sarcodines are the Entamoeba histolytica, which causes the amoeboid dysentery. So another important sarcodines is the Entamoeba histolytica, causing amoeboid dysentery. Apart from sarcodines, there are another group are called the sporozoa. They actually produces, they have parasitic mode of life. So another group is the sporozoa. Sporozoa, they are the parasites. Clear? They are commonly they are parasites. All them of them are endoparasites. That means they live within the body of the organism. They are covered with pellicle. Generally, they do not have any locomotory organ like flagella, cilia, pseudopodia, or like that. They reproduces by multiple fission, that means cell divides into numerous, and finally each of them numerous small cells, and finally each of them develops into new individual. And if we consider their life cycle, we find that they have very distinct, two distinct phases in their life cycle. One is the asexual phase and other is the sexual phase. Clear? The asexual phase by multiple fission, and sexual phase obviously by the fusion of gametes. Now, one of the example of this group is the Plasmodium. So Plasmodium is another one example, most important one example of this group. You know that Plasmodium vivax is causal agent of malaria. It it causes the disease called malaria. And how it is transmitted? So in humans, so obviously it is causing the disease of malaria. So it remains as a parasite within the human being. And how it is transmitted to human being? It is transmitted by the female Anopheles mosquito. So female Anopheles mosquito is one of the host, and human being is the other host in this, of this group. And this in this human being, they perform their asexual phase of life cycle, and in mosquito they perform the sexual phase of their life cycle. So they have distinct asexual and sexual phase in their life cycle. Another example is monocystis. So there is, so another one is the ciliated protozoan. So you can see here lots of cilia throughout their body surface. So throughout their body surface they have cilia, and these cilia mainly help them in locomotion as well as driving their food. And see the ciliate, the movement by cilia is very fast, clear? So they can move very fast. Their body is covered by fine pellicle. And another interesting thing which they show is the nuclear dimorphism. You can see here two nuclei. Clear, one is the larger one which is responsible for their growth and is called vegetative nucleus, and another one is the smaller one, micronucleus, which is responsible for reproduction. So macronucleus for vegetative nucleus for growth, and micronucleus or small nucleus for reproduction. Asexual reproduction by transverse binary fission. Asexual reproduction is mainly by the transverse binary fission, sexual reproduction by conjugation, clear? And very common ciliates are the ciliated protozoan are the paramecium. Very common ciliated protozoan is the paramecium. You know, you are very familiar with the picture because you have seen it from very earlier classes also. And you can see here they have a very oral group, well developed oral group, buccal cavity which is associated with food vacuole, and they have distinct contractile vacuole for osmoregulation. So this is about the ciliated protozoans. So ultimately we have completed the protists.